Together, we are going to start a new energy revolution, one that celebrates American production on American soil.
Joining us now, Bill Nye, the Science Guy. Bill, thank you very much for joining us tonight. Could you start with what is coal and what is clean coal?
Coal is ancient swamp that's been dried out and compressed. So when you burn it, you're burning ancient plant material and putting carbon dioxide that's been sequestered under the Earth's crust, the soil, for hundreds of millions of years. You're putting it back in the atmosphere about a million times faster than it was created. Clean coal is, we argue about this, it's just a misnomer. You're making carbon dioxide, which is causing the world to warm faster than it ever has warmed in history. And this will have tremendous consequences for everyone in the world. Clean coal is a myth. I know the previous president referred to it as well, but he was doing his best. Right now, the unintended consequences, I think, will be remarkable. First of all, if they, through Russiagate or whatever, they choose to shut down the government, this will empower states even more. And so the states with a little more sophisticated energy policies like California will impose harder restrictions, for example, on cars manufactured in Michigan. And so this will influence the U.S. economy in a way that was probably not intended by this executive order. Furthermore, it's another executive order. So they're going to, I imagine, there will be lawsuits to undo it because it's against the actual regulations and laws, which are already in place by the Environmental Protection Agency. The guys who are going to make out here, Mr. O'Donnell, Lawrence, are the coal magnates. Those are the rich, those certain rich people stand to get richer.
You mean like Wilbur Ross, the Secretary of Commerce, who is himself a coal magnate?
Yeah, and so everybody, just from a scientific standpoint, there's nothing worse than burning coal. This is the worst thing. Maybe the tar sands in Alberta, but there's very few things worse than coal, and we need to stop right away. And I give this example all the time. My grandfather went into World War I on a horse. Nobody who conducts a war nowadays does that on a horse. There were stables, there were mews, there were livery, there was a whole business supporting horseback riding in the city of New York, for example, Washington, D.C., Boston, Philadelphia. Those people aren't in that business anymore. They went to do something else. In the same way, if you are a coal miner, you're in the heartland, you're what J.D. Vance calls a hillbilly, and you're proud, you don't want to be in the coal business because it's not going to be around much longer. And if you work in the mines, you know how it's getting automated. Your job's not going to be preserved. We want you, we in the engineering community, want you to get involved in new renewable energy. A striking thing, a remarkable thing, nuclear power is affected by this because it gets some benefits legally by being clean. So by rolling back these traditional regulations, you're even affecting the nuclear industry. It's remarkable.
Sean Spicer was asked a simple yes or no question today. I would like you to grade his answer. It's a little tricky because he didn't say yes or no. The question was, does the president still believe in that climate change is a hoax? Let's watch this.
Does the president still believe that climate change is a hoax?
I think you'll hear more today about the climate and what he believes. I think he understands. He does not believe that, as I mentioned at the outset, there is a binary choice between job creation, economic growth, and caring about the environment.
Bill, you've got about 40 seconds to grade that answer.
Well, taken on its own, it would be great. Yes, if we had solar, wind, some geothermal, some tidal energy, we can run the whole place, the entire United States, Canada, we can run 130 countries in the world right now if we just decided to do it. Check out the Solutions Project. org. These are civil engineers, electrical engineers who've done an analysis. This could be done. Burning coal is bad for everybody. Everybody, we have to stop it as soon as we can. Let's get to work. We can change the world.
Did you see any problem in, like, why Sean Spicer wasn't able to say yes or no to does the president believe that climate change is a hoax? That would be a yes or no, wouldn't it?
It would be normally, but you know, Mr. Spicer is, he's constrained. He has to speak for somebody who's not all engaged all the time. Thank you, Lawrence, for discussing this. May the facts be with you.
Hey, Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.